What I have here is the list of ages of the students in a class. And what I want to explore in this video is different ways of representing this data and then see if we can answer questions about the data. So the first way we can think about it is as a frequency table. Frequency table. Frequency table. And what we're going to do is we're going to look at each possible age that we've measured here, see how many students in the class are of that age. So we could say the age is one column, and then the number of students of that age, or we could even say the frequency. Frequency. When people say how frequent do you do something, they're saying how often does it happen? How often do you do that thing? Frequency. Or we could also say, actually, let me just write number. I'm always a fan of the simpler number at age, which we could also consider the frequency at that age. The frequency of students. All right. So what's the lowest age that we have here? Well, the lowest age is 5. So I'll start with 5. And how many students in the class are age 5? How frequent is the number 5? Let's see, there is 1, 2. Let me keep scanning. Looks like there's only 2 5s. So I could write a 2 here. There are 2 5s. And now let's go to 6. How many 6s are there? Let's see, there is 1 6. There's only 1 6-year-old in the class. All right, 7-year-olds. Let's see, there's 1, 2, 3, 4 7-year-olds. 4 7-year-olds. Now what about 8-year-olds? 8-year-olds, I'm gonna do this in a color that I have not used yet. 8-year-olds, we have no 8-year-olds. 0 8-year-olds. And then we have 9-year-olds. Let's see. 9-year-olds, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 9-year-olds. 4 9-year-olds. 10-year-olds, what do we have? We have 1 10-year-old right over there. And then 11-year-olds. 11-year-olds, there are no 11-year-olds. And then, let me scroll up a little bit. And then finally, 12-year-olds. 12-year-olds, there are 1, 2 12-year-olds. So what we have just constructed is a frequency table. It's a frequency table. You can see for each age how many students are at that age. So it's giving you the same information as we have up here. You could take this table and construct what we have up here. You would just write down 2 5s, 1 6s, 4 7s, no 8s, 4 9s, 1 10, no 11s, and 2 12s. And then you would just have this list of numbers. Now a way to visually look at a frequency table is a dot plot. So let me draw a dot plot right over here. So a dot plot. And a dot plot, we essentially just take the same information and even think about it the same way, but we just show it visually. So in a dot plot, what we would have, let me just not draw an even arrow there. We have the different age groups. So 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. And we have a dot to represent, or we use a dot for each student at that age. So there's 2 5-year-olds, so I'll do 2 dots. 1 and 2. There's 1 6-year-old, so that's going to be 1 dot. Right over here. There's 4 7-year-olds, so 1, 2, 3, 4 dots. There's no 8-year-olds, there's 4 9-year-olds. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. There's 1 10-year-old. So let's put a dot, 1 dot right over there for that 1 10-year-old. There's no 11-year-old, so I'm not going to put any dots there. And then there's 2 12-year-olds. So 1 12-year-old and another 12-year-old. So there you go. We have frequency table, dot plot, list of numbers. These are all showing the same data, just in different ways. And once you have it represented in any of these ways, we can start to ask questions about it. So we could say, what is the most frequent age? Well, the most frequent age, when you look at it visually, the easiest thing might be just look at the dot plot because you see it visually, the most frequent age are the two highest stacks. So there's actually 7 and 9 are tied for the most frequent age. You would have also seen it here, where 7 and 9 are tied at 4. And if you just had this data, you'd have to count all of them to kind of come up with this again and say, okay, there's 4 sevens, 4 nines, that's the largest number. So this is, if you're looking for what's the most frequent age, when you just visually inspect here, it probably pops out at you the fastest. But there's other questions we can ask ourselves. We can ask ourselves, what is the range? What is the range of ages in the classroom? And this is once again where maybe the dot plot is the most, it jumps out at you the most, because the range is just the maximum age in your, or the maximum data point minus the minimum data point. So what's the maximum age here? Well, the maximum age here, we see it from this, from the dot plot, is 12. And the minimum age here, you see, is 5. So there's a range of 7. The difference between the maximum and the minimum is 7. But you could have also done that over here. You could say, hey, the maximum age here is 12, minimum age here is 5. And so subtract from 5. you find the difference between 12 and 5, which is 7. Here, you would have done, have to do, you still could have done it. You could say, okay, what's the lowest? Let's look at 5. Are there any 4s here? Nope, there's no 4s. So 5 is the minimum age. And what's the largest? Is it 7? No. Is it 9? 10? Oh, 12. 12. Are there any 13s? No. 12 is the maximum. So you say 12 minus 5 is 7 to get the range. But then we could ask ourselves other questions. We could say, how many older than 9 is a question we could ask ourselves. And then if we were to look at the dot plot, we say, okay, this is 9, and we care about how many are older than 9. So that would be this 1, 2, and 3. Or you could look over here, how many are older than 9? Well, it's the one person who's 10, and then the two who are 12. So there are 3. And over here, if you said how many are older than 9, well, then you would just have to go through the list and say, okay, no. Okay, here, 1, 2, 3, and then not that person right over there. So hopefully this is just an appreciation for yet another two ways of looking at data, frequency tables and dot plots.